我们都很喜欢单纯的人事物。
We like people that are simple and straightforward or pure.
大家都希望能够过着一个单纯的生活。
And people like to live simple lives.
有一个很单纯的人际关系。
And people like to have simple interhuman relationships.
我们希望我们所使用的语言呢，很单纯，不是很复杂。
And we like to hear and use simple language.
中文呢，对我们来说是很简单。单纯啊。
To the Chinese language is very simple.
因为他，男的他，女的他，都是他，都是他，没有这个男女之区别的，没有 she 跟 he。
The pronouns in Chinese have no differentiation between the genders.
我要去学校，今天去，明天去，后天去，都是去。也是一样的字没有，并没有过去式、现在是未来式。
And there's no differentiation of tense in the Chinese verb.
有的语言呢就很复杂。
Some languages are more difficult.
光是一个词呢，要十七种十七种用法。
One word or phrase can be used in 17 different ways.
比较葡文就非常复杂。
For example, Portuguese is quite difficult.
那这个很难学的。
And it's very difficult to learn it.
所以我们都希望有一个单纯的语言啊，语言越简单越好。
We all prefer simpler languages.
那我们的头脑也是一样，头脑要越单纯越好了。
And our minds also need to be simple.
那其实主耶稣也是希望我们过着一个很单纯、很简单的生活。
Our Lord Jesus also wants us to live a simple life.
我们请看马太福音。
Please turn to Matthew.
马太福音第五章。
Matthew chapter 5.
马太福音第五章第八节。
Matthew chapter 5 verse 8.
马太福音第五章第八节。
Matthew chapter 5 verse 8.
清心的人有福了，因为他们必得见神。
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
主耶稣来世间的时候，他就开始传道了，说天国近了，我们要悔改。
When the Lord Jesus began to preach in the world, he said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
所以可见人们在生活生活上的生活方式跟神国的原则是不一样的。
We can see then that the principle of life in this world and in the kingdom of God is different.
神的国就是公义、和平、喜乐。
In the kingdom of God, life is about righteousness,peace and joy.
这些呢，神要赏赐给我们。
And these are the things God will give us.
可是呢，已经快临近了，还没有到一个快临近的。
And the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It is not here yet.
那什么时候能够临到我们身上呢
？And when does it actually become realized in us？
就是我们要转向，我们要改变我们想法。
It requires for us to change ourselves and change our mindset.
因为主耶稣在传福音的时候，登山宝训就讲到很多有心理建设的问题。
In the teachings on the Mount, the Lord Jesus talked about reconstructing one's heart.
那当然，主耶稣所教训的是在以前旧约时代所缺乏的。
And what he taught were things that were missing under the old covenant.
所以他说，清心的人有福了。
He said, "Blessed are the pure in heart."
就是在心里面清心在心里面清洁、干净、单纯。
A person needs to be pure in his heart.
因为一生的果效都是从心里面发出来的。
Because from the heart comes the spring of life.
那一个人所想的是善的话，他所做的、他所说的也是善的。
And if a person thinks good in his heart, his words and his actions are good.
那假如一个人念心是存有邪念，那他说的话会伤害到别人呢？他所做的事情也是会伤害到别人的利益。
But if a person's heart is wicked, his words and his actions will hurt others.
所以心是非常重要的。
Therefore, the heart is very important.
因此，我们要改正我们的动作，改正我们的行为，就是要从心的意念开始。
If we want to change our minds and our actions, we need to start with our heart.
所以主耶稣说清心的人有福了。
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Blessed are the pure in spirit."
那我们来看看到底什么叫做清心的人。
We'll now discuss what does it mean to be pure in heart.
我们首先呢来看诗篇。
Please turn to Psalms.
诗篇二十四篇。
Psalm 24.
诗篇二十四篇第三节。
Verse 3.
第三节。
Verse 3.
谁能够登主的山？谁能够站在他的圣所？第四节
，four
啊，就是守节心清、不向虚妄起誓、不怀诡诈的人。
Who may ascend into the hill of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul to an idol, nor sworn deceitfully.
所以这里告诉我们什么是清心的人。
This passage teaches us what it means to be pure in heart.
哎，就是踏实啊，不怀诡诈的人。
To be honest, to be without deceit.
那为什么要怀诡诈呢？
Why would a person be deceitful?
因为人有贪心啊，人的思想意念啊，动机啊不纯正。
Because a person may be greedy and he may have ulterior motives.
那他可能想去伤害到别人啊。
And he may want to hurt others.
他可能要从别人那个地方多夺取一些利益。
He may want to gain profit from someone else.
啊，最好呢是全部都是归给他的。
And he could only wish that he owns everything.
但是谁愿意遭受损失呢？
But nobody wants to suffer loss.
所以你要是把动机表明出来的话，那大家都会防备的。
So if a person's intentions become clear, everyone will stay away from this person.
你看那些骗子啊，他会不会说，哎，朱勇，我现在要开始骗你了哦？
Those people who commit fraud would not tell others, I'm going to trick you now.
不会的啦，他还是要骗的，他还是装得很，假装得很善良的。
Such people would always pretend to be good people.
他肯定会请你吃饭啊。
They would invite you to a meal.
还会买东西送给你啊。
They would buy you gifts.
让你不怀疑他的动机。
So that you are completely prepared to defend yourself against his motive.
因此，这种人必须要伪装。
So they must pretend.
但是呢，心清的人呢，动机很单纯、很善良的人呢，他不需要这样子。
But a person who is pure in heart, who has no ulterior motive, does not need to pretend.
他不需要伪装。
He does not need to disguise himself.
那我们现在社会的人呢，有没有清心呢？
Are the people in this world pure in heart?
有很多书籍啊，都告诉我们要怎么去伪装自己。
Many books teach us how to be somebody who we're not.
怎么样去改善自己的形象
？And how to change our image.
这叫做伪装术啊。
All these are tactics in disguise.
但是呢，圣经告诉我们，说谁能够站在主的圣所了
？But what does the Bible say about who can stand in the holy place of God？
就是心清的人，清心的人。
He who has a pure heart.
那心清的人，他的动机也很单纯。
He who has a pure heart has a pure motive.
所以他不会怀诡诈，不需要化妆的，不需要伪装。
He does not disguise himself.
那跟这种人在一起也是很，我们跟他们在一起也是很好办事情，很放心。
And we can be at ease when we are with such people.
因为他们做人的很踏实，做事情啊是实实在在的做事情。
Because they are upright and honest in what they do.
他们说的跟想的做的啊，所做的所说的都跟所想的一样。
Their actions and their speech correspond to what they think.
因此他们的内心很清澈，很清，那我们外人呢也可以看得很清楚。
Their heart is pure, and everyone around him can see that.
那当然有的人的内心我们看不清楚啊。
There are people whose heart is difficult to decipher.
因为他经常会改变。
Because they often change,
他经常会伪装
and they pretend to be someone else.
所以他内心真正在想什么，我们看不清楚
So we can't really tell what they're thinking.
所以他内心呢，就好像是很污浊啊，就很不清澈，看不清楚
Their heart is very muddled and difficult to see through.
所以清心的人，也就是很踏实的人呢，心口一致的
But a pure person pure in heart is one who is upright, who is consistent in his thoughts and his speech and actions.
另外一个意义啊，也就是诗篇。
Let's look at another meaning of pure in heart.
诗篇十五篇。
Please read Psalm 15.
诗篇十五篇。
Psalm 15.
第一节。
Verse 1.
十五篇第一节。
Psalm 15, verse 1.
主啊，谁能够寄居你的帐幕？谁能够住在你的圣山？那这个就是跟二十四。篇啊，是差不多的， 神够站在主的圣山。
Lord, who may abide in your tabernacle, who may dwell in your holy hill, this recalls Psalm 24.
然后第二节就说明了。
Verse 2 explains.
啊，就是行为正直，做事公义，心里说实话的人。
He who walks uprightly and works righteousness and speaks the truth in his heart.
说心清的人，也就是心里说实话的人。
So a person pure in heart is one who speaks the truth in his heart.
啊，说话呢不加油添醋。
He does not distort words.
那不加油添醋很难呢。
And it's and he does not exaggerate, which is difficult to do.
啊，有些时候我们在玩游戏哈，这二十个人排一排呀、啊。那把信息传给第一个人、啊、叫他一直传下去，到第二十个人，完全走样。
In a game where you pass on a message from one person to the next, you by the time it reaches the last person, the message becomes completely different.
啊，以前我在天马教会注目的时候
，When I was stationed at Tampa Church，
啊，很多信徒很好奇，说我的我在住在芝加哥的房子怎么样啊，多大啦、啊，怎么样啊，很好奇呀、啊。
Many members were curious about what kind of house I lived in Chicago.
所以我说老师告诉他们说两千多个 square feet.
So I told them I lived in a 2,000 square feet house.
好，那过了大概一个月以后
，After a month or so,
有个信徒告诉我，有个姐妹告诉我了。
A sister told me.
说你的房子啊，听说是五千多个 square feet.
I heard that you lived in a 5,000 square feet house.
感谢主啊，一个月就加一倍大也是不错的、啊。
Thank God, if I could, my house can expand more than twice a year, a month. That's pretty good.
才传几个人
So even though the message went through only a few people,
哎，就走样了的
It became very different.
两千多变成五千多
2,000 square feet became 5,000 square feet.
再一个月呢，就变成一万多
After a month, it could be 10,000 feet.
那就可以开仓库了
Then I could open a warehouse.
所以话一传以后。经常会走样
，so messages or words get distorted.
但是呢，心清的人哈，他说话诚实，不会加油添醋。
But a person who is pure in heart speaks the truth and does not exaggerate.
啊，不会夸张啊，不会渲染。
And he will not be boastful.
啊，说话很实在。
And he is genuine in his words.
啊，让人很喜欢听啊，因为他说话很实在啊。
People like to hear what they say because they are truthful.
那假设说话加油添醋的话，那他自己要负责任。
But if a person likes to exaggerate and distort things, then he has to be responsible for what he does.
万一有人查下去的话，说这是谁说的
？Because eventually, when the truth comes out, people will question who said this.
那些加油添醋的人就开始紧张了。
And then if the person exaggerated, then he will be in trouble.
那心就不清了啦，因为他怕来问啊，他加油添醋是不对的啦。
His heart would not be pure, and he would be afraid of being questioned.
说心清的人啊，说话老实。
So a person who is pure in heart speaks the truth.
啊，就是按照啊所听的去传讲。
He preaches. He passes on the message exactly as he has heard it.
那主耶稣就是这种人呢、啊。
And this is what our Lord Jesus is like.
圣经说，主耶稣从天父那边听到什么信息，他就传给我们。
Because he said that whatever he has heard from the Father, he tells us.
你看那些法利赛人要试探耶稣，那边那些人也是肯定主耶稣讲话很实在。
When the Pharisees came to test Jesus, they first conceded that Jesus was very truthful in his words.
说主耶稣是个清心的人呢。
So our Lord Jesus is a person of pure heart.
因为他说话不加油添醋。
Because he does not exaggerate or distort.
那看第三种人哈。
Let's look at the third type of persons.
来看一样的十五章第四节啊。
Let's read Psalm 15 verse 4.
十五章第四节。
Psalm 15 verse 4.
他眼中藐视匪类，却尊重那些敬畏主的人。
In whose eyes a vile person is despised, but honors those who fear the Lord.
啊，眼中藐视匪类，这个匪类就是做为非作歹的人呢、啊。伤害别人的人
，A vile person is a criminal, one who hurts others.
那当然对这种人呢、啊，要轻视啊。
And of course, we need to despise such people.
因为不值得去学习，不值得去效法他们的行为。
Because they are not worthy of imitation.
可是他要尊重那些敬畏神的人。
But the one who is pure in heart honors those who fear the Lord.
所以清心的人啊，他们四分能够分清楚。
A person who is pure in heart can discern right from wrong.
哪一种人是好人，哪一种人是坏人？
They can tell who are evil and who are good.
啊，现在有的社会啊，这个分不清啊。
In this world, sometimes it's difficult to tell.
是非啊，分不清。
There's always a confusion, often a confusion of right and wrong.
因为现在的人啊。在论是跟非啊，不是根据道德观念的、
Because today people often do not make moral judgments based on do not make judgments based on moral standards.
啊，不是用我们老祖宗啊他们的想法。
And they do not follow the ways of the former generation.
而是呢，用多数人啊，多数人说对，那就对了啦。
Today it is the majority who decides what is right and wrong.
啊，不管多数人的想法啊，是不是合乎圣经，是不是合乎我们以前的道德的观念。
Regardless of whether what the majority thinks conforms to the Bible.
只要多数人说对啊，那就对了。
The majority decides what is right.
啊，就变成法律。
It becomes a law.
啊，大家就必须要遵守啊。
And people must follow the majority's decision.
不管里面的圣经怎么说。
It does not matter what the Bible says.
说今天的人啊，是非就分不清啊。
So there is confusion of right and wrong today.
因为我们都被民族啊这两个字骗了。
Because we have been deceived by the word democracy.
我们想想，当时摩西先派十二个探子啊去探迦南地。
When Moses sent the 12 spies into Canaan.
十个人呢、啊，是绝大多数的人说我们不能够去啊，去不了啊。
10 out of the 12 spies came back and said we must not go into that land.
因为那个地方的人人高马大。
Because the people of that land are giants.
我们很弱小，我们不是他们的对手啊。
We are so tiny, we are no match of theirs.
所以结论就是我们不能去。
So they concluded that they must not enter that land.
一去的话会被他们消灭的。
Or else they would be consumed.
只有两个人说可以去。
And only two people said that they must go.
这两个人为什么说可以去？他们是凭着信心呢、啊？
They said that they could go into the land because they said these words by faith.
因为他们所看见的那个环境啊，是跟那十个人一样的。
They were looking at the same environment that the ten spies.The 10 other spies were looking at.
但是那两个人是凭着神的应许来说话。
But they spoke by the faith in God's promise.
凭着神的应许来说对还是错。
By God's promise, they decided what was right and wrong.
那其他的人啊，就不是凭着神的应许啊。
But the other spies did not do so through God's promise.
所以今天的人的是非也不是根据神的话来的。
So today, in today's society, people's standard of right and wrong is not based on God.
所以心不清啊。
And this is not being pure in heart.
啊，心不清的话，他的做了决定也会错的。
And when a person is not pure in heart, he often makes the wrong decision.
好像保罗啊，他说他向神跟向人啊都要求良心啊无愧啊。
Paul said that he always demanded having a pure conscience before God and before others.
我们请看约翰一书啊。
Let's turn to 1 John.
约翰一书第三章。
1 John chapter 3.
21节。
Verse 21.
21节。
Verse 21.
约翰一书第三章21节。
1 John chapter 3 verse 21.
亲爱的弟兄啊，我们的心啊，若不责备我们，就可以向神坦然无惧的。
Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence toward God.
叫良心清洁。
This means to be pure in heart.
那我们就可以向神坦然无惧呀、
啊。If we can be such if we can be confident like this, we can be confident toward God.
心中就没有害怕。Mm.
We will have no fear in our heart.
那这种清心的人哦，就能够得到平安跟喜乐。
Such people who have a pure heart can have peace and joy.
因为他们是非能够分得清楚。
They are able to discern right and wrong very clearly.
那该恨恶了就恨恶，非的呀就不能够跟他同一帮，不能够赞同他的做法。
They despise a vile person and would not stand on their side.
啊，敬畏神的人就必须要支持他，鼓励他。
Whereas they would support and encourage those who fear the Lord.
啊，那再看第四种，第四种清心的人。
Now let's look at the fourth type of people who are pure in heart.
啊，请看回到诗篇十五篇。
Please go back to Psalm 15.
诗篇十五篇第四节。
Psalm 15 verse 4.
第四节啊，下半段。
The second part.
他发了誓，虽然自己吃亏，也不更改。
He who swears to his own hurt and does not change.
所以清心的人，也就是宁愿吃亏的人呢。
Those who are pure in heart are those who would uphold their integrity to their own hurt.
啊，当然一般的人啊，谁愿意吃亏？
People don't like to be hurt or to be to suffer loss.
啊，所谓吃亏的话，就是可能你的权益受损害。
And to be taken advantage of, or
你的财产遭到损失啊。
This could mean material wealth, suffering financially.
可清心的人啊，他们就是自己吃亏，也不改变的。
But a person who is pure in heart would not change his stance, even when it is to his own hurt.
所以有一句话说啊，吃亏啊，就是占便宜。
There is a saying, to be taken advantage of is to take advantage of others.
那这句话很难懂啊。
That's difficult to understand.
吃亏怎么还会占便宜呢？
How can you be a loser and a winner at the same time?
那这一句话的背后，其实还有一句话没有讲出来啊。
This statement needs elaboration.
这一句话啊，中文，我先用台湾话讲啊。谈的话比较传神啊，叫天公啊，听戆人，叫做天父啊，照顾那些单纯的人呢。
There's a Taiwanese saying that the Heavenly Father takes care of those who are pure.
啊，有位弟兄啊，他跟有位没有信主的朋友啊，来共同买一块地。
There is a brother in church who bought a piece of land with a friend outside of church.
啊，那一块是农地啊。
It was farmland.
啊，但农地现在是暂时啊，不是说很值钱啊。
And at that time, it wasn't worth much.
啊，后来两个人就啊，我们还是把它分割了，分割。
In the end, the two of them decided to split the land.
所以那位不是基督徒的人，他就自己啊，把自己啊分割一块很好的地方给自己。
His unbelieving friend managed to divide the land in such a way that he got the better part of the land.
那我们这位信徒啊，就被分配到那个区域啊比较不好，就是那里有什么高压线呐，啊，又是区那个反正地方不是很好的地段。
But this brother got the other part of the land, which was much more inferior.
啊，也不是靠近马路了。
And it was very far from a street.
所以啊，很不值钱。
It was not worth much at all.
但是这位信徒啊，没有说什么话了。
But this church member did not say anything.
因为他记住神的话。
He remembered God's word.
啊，吃亏就是占便宜。
To be taken advantage of being makes you a winner.
因为他在敬畏神的人。
Because he feared the Lord.
虽然吃亏也不更改啊。
Even though he suffered disadvantage, he did not change his integrity.
啊，那过了几个月以后，
after a few months,
啊，政府有个都市计划。
The government had a new city planning.
土地啊，重新规划。
So they rezoned the different lots of lands.
结果他们那个农地啊，就变成建地啊。
So that farmland became a land for construction.
我们信徒这块地啊，就变成最值钱的。
And it turned out that this piece of land that our brother owned became very, very valuable.
因为本来不是马路，现在变成马路旁边了。
Originally, it was very far from a street, but now it was right by a street.
还有是那个转弯的那corner地方呢。
And it was a corner lot.
所以就变成最值钱了。
So it became very valuable.
所以说啊，吃亏就是占便宜了。
So that's what they mean when they say to be taken advantage of is actually becoming a winner.
可是当时在吃亏的时候，那的确是真的是吃亏。
But at the time, this brother was really at a disadvantage.
但是吃亏的人，他把他的所有权 全部交在神的手中。
Yet despite his disadvantage, he entrusted everything in God's hand.
因为他敬畏神啊。
Because he feared God.
所以清心的人啊，就不会去跟其他的人计较。
So a person who is pure in heart would not quarrel with others.
他宁可吃亏，不与别人吵架。
They would rather suffer hurt than to fight with others.
也不会自己争取最大的利益。
And they would not fight for their own interests.
所以他能够睡得着啊。
So they are able to sleep in peace.
清心。
They are pure in heart.
再来看十五章第五节。
Let's read Psalm 15 verse 5.
十五章第五节。
Psalm 15 verse 5.
他不放债取利，不受贿赂，以害无辜，行这些事的人必永不动摇。
He who does not put out his money at usury, but does he take a bribe against the innocent, nor does he take a bribe against the innocent.
说第五种啊，是不贪小便宜的人。
So the fifth type of people who are pure in heart are those who are not greedy for gain.
啊，放债取利当然是能够得到一些利益。
To put out money at usury means to try to gain as much profit as possible.
啊，很多人啊受骗呢。
Many people are tricked.
那为什么会受骗
？Why are they tricked？
当然，他们就是贪小便宜呀。
Because they were greedy to begin with.
因为有人说啊，你要投资的话，你看一年啊，你先投资一万块，第二年我就还你哈一万五啊，报酬率是50%。
Because people come and tell them that if you invest $10,000 this year, you will get double next year.
好不好呢？
Is that a great deal?
要不要参加？来参加。
Why did you come and join this venture?
你先交给我一万块。
Give me $10,000.
明年再还给你一万五。
I'll give you $150,000.
啊，现在利息很低啊。
$15,000 next year.
啊，不需要往哪里投资。
And now it's because the interest rate is so low, and you don't know where to invest your money.
啊，叶传道做人很老实。
And preacher Ye is such an honest man.
啊，你看，还是。来参加他这个投资计划吧。
Why don't I join his venture?
好，明年呢，哎，真的给你一万五啊。
And the next year you actually get $15,000.
后年就不给了。
And then the second year you don't get anything.
哎，所以有就是被欺骗了。
This is how people get tricked.
就贪小便宜呀。
Because they are greedy.
有的人是血本无归呀。
Some people lose everything.
连那个退休金都赔进去的。
They even lose their retirement.
就是贪小便宜。
The savings. And this is how they. This is because they're greedy.
那你看贪小便宜的话会吃大亏呀。
And people who are greedy will tend to lose a lot.
那这种的心怎么能够清啊
？And they cannot be pure in heart.
他经常要去讨钱，要去讨那些钱回来的。
They will think about is how to get their money back.
因此啊。这个清心的人啊，就是不贪小便宜。
So a person who is pure in heart, would not be greedy for gain.
因此圣经说啊，清心的人有福了。
So the Bible says, blessed are the pure in heart.
因为他们必得见神，要看见神呐。
For they shall see God.
那为什么说他们是有福
？Why are they blessed?
我们请看诗篇十七篇。
Please read Psalm 17.
诗篇十七篇十五节。
Psalm 17 verse 15.
诗篇十七篇十五节。
Psalm 17 verse 15.
至于我，我必在异中见你的面。我醒了的时候，得见你的形象，就心满意足了。
As for me, I will see your face in righteousness. I shall be satisfied when I awake in your likeness.
当然，我们或许会说，看到神有什么了不起的
？We may say, what's the big deal about seeing God's face?
但是见到神的形象，会让人心满意足，嘿。
But a person would be satisfied when he sees God's likeness.
啊，听到上礼拜张妈妈在这里看到异象。
I heard that last week, Sister Chang saw a vision here.
啊，看到主的荣光。
She saw the glorious light of the Lord.
啊，天使啊向她显现。
She saw the angel of God.
然后她看得非常高兴，非常喜乐。
She was so satisfied and joyful.
啊，那种喜乐的心啊，是很难用言语来表达的。
That kind of joy and satisfaction are hard to describe with words.
你看她藏不住了，她就马上告诉其他弟兄姐妹呢。
She could not contain her joy and had to share with everyone else.
她笑马上就分享啊。
And she was able to share it in the afternoon.
看到神的本身啊，那是一种喜乐无比的事情啊。
So to see God Himself and His likeness is something very joyful.
所以彼得他形容说，那个喜乐是无法用言语来表达的。
And Peter
说不出来的大喜乐。
Peter calls it a great and inexpressible joy.
能够说得出来的就没有什么了。
Something
不是说很喜乐。
That can be expressed in words would not be the greatest joy.
我们经常说啊，我爱你啊，你爱我啦，大家爱来爱去是对。
We often use the words "I love you."
你看这个先生要去上班呐，要告诉太太说 "I love you"， 然后才去上班呐。
When the husband goes to work, he would say to his wife, "I love you" before going to work.
啊，太太听起来很高兴，很安慰的。哇，我先生很喜欢我。
That makes the wife happy because she knows how much he loves her.
啊，就是到今天还是很爱我的。
And he still loves me today.
好，那我们有的从中国来的哈，我们中国人呢都比较不会讲这句话。
But people from Asia, from China, would not be more hesitant to say words like that.
不善于表达说我爱你呀。
They are not good at expressing their love.
但其实也很爱太太呀。
Even though they really love their spouse, their wives.
那个内心的爱啊，是很难用言语来表达的。
And this kind of feeling in their heart sometimes are difficult to express.
那个说不出来的爱才是最高级的。
The love that cannot be expressed is actually the greatest love.
能够被用言语来形容的、来表达的，还算是初级啊。
Feelings that can be expressed with words are only secondary or a little inferior.
啊，人间有很多那个风景区啊，非常漂亮。
In this world, there are many places of nature or places of scenery that are very beautiful.
那大家去观赏以后啊，说哇，那个地方很好啊，那个瀑布啊，哇，很漂亮，很壮观。
And tourists will flock to these places. For example, they would say how beautiful the waterfall is.
啊，是可以用言语来表达的。
And they try to express their feelings with their words.
可是保罗他说那个天国的美好啊，是很难用言语来表达。
But Paul told us that the wonder of the heavenly kingdom is beyond words.
所以他到了第三层天以后
，After he reached the third heaven，
啊，他又回到原来的啊，又醒过来呀
，and returned to earth。
那可能他还想做见证啊
，Maybe he tried to witness what he saw。
那大家请他做见证啊
，and maybe people tried to invite him to witness。
说你讲啊讲啊，到底是多么好啊
，and to share how wonderful heaven is。
他讲不出来呀。
But he could not express it.
他说他 speechless， 他实在是不知道用什么话来讲。
He was speechless.
啊，你去就知道了。
You have to go there to experience it. 啊，
所以我们不要犯罪了，我们要去那里呀。
So we must not sin. We must all go there.
我们看到神就心满意足。
When we see God, we will be satisfied.
说清心的人，他们的内心啊是经常是满意的，是知足的。
Therefore, those who are pure in heart are always satisfied.
啊，这种是用金钱的换不来的。
This is something that money cannot buy.
这个是最有福气。
And this is the greatest blessing.
那第二种福呢？啊，神会恩待清心的人。
The second blessing given to the pure in heart is the grace of God.
啊，请看诗篇。
Please turn to Psalms.
73篇第1节。
Psalm 73:1.
73篇第1节。
Psalm 73:1。
神实在恩待以色列那些清心的人。
Truly, God is good to Israel, to such as are pure in heart.
作者根据我们中文念的说，实在恩待以色列那些清心的人，好像是暂时呢看不出来神恩待那些清心的人，暂时的看不出来。
英文没有。
没关系，你就说中文。
Okay, the Chinese seems to suggest that it's a temporary blessing.
啊，的确，你假如读七十三篇呢、啊，假如读七十三篇的话，那就知道神真的恩待那些清心的人。可是呢，暂时是看不出来的。七十三篇读完了以后，你要读全部的七十三篇读完了才知道。
Only by the end.If you read Chinese, you will understand this verse by the end of the psalm.
所以我们有些时候轻信，但是呢，轻信呢，你看眼睛会受吃亏的。
Those who are pure in heart may suffer loss at the moment.
但是呢，他不改变啊。
But they do not change their stance.
但后来呢，神会报赏他。
In the end, they will be rewarded.
所以神真的是恩待那些清心的人。
So truly, God is good to those who are pure in heart.
经常不会让他们吃亏哦。
They would not, in the end, they would not suffer loss.
但有时候看起来眼前好像是吃亏的样子的。
Maybe at the moment, they may seem to be at a disadvantage.
好像大家现在来参加聚会。
For example, when we come to service,
也好像是吃亏啊。
We may seem to be at a disadvantage.
因为来这里没有什么好玩的啦。
Because there's nothing fun here.
去百货公司逛街比较好玩啊。
It's more fun going shopping.
去哪边 barbecue 比较好玩啊。
Or to go barbecue.
跟朋友聊天比较好玩啊。
Or to have a chat with a friend.
但是大家来这里啊，神会恩待大家。
But when we come here, God will be gracious to us.
但是可能马上看不出来啊。你现在看不出来。
The result may not be immediate.
但是以后就知道了。
But it will become clear eventually.
但是神会恩待我们。
That God is good to us.
好像我刚举的那个弟兄一样啊，那个买田的那个弟兄一样。
Like the example of that brother who purchased the land with his friend.
到后来神还是会照顾他。
Ultimately, God was good to him.
好，那我们看影响轻信的原因到底是什么？
Let's now talk about the factors that affect being pure in heart.
为什么有人不清心？
Why is it that some people cannot be pure in heart?
第一个原因就是生活物质的忧虑与吸引。
The first factor is the attraction of material life.
请看路加福音二十一章。
Please turn to Luke chapter 21.
路加福音二十一章三十四节。
Luke 21 verse 34.
路加福音二十一章三十四节。
Luke 21 verse 34.
你们要谨慎，恐怕因贪食醉酒，并今生的思虑啊，勒住你们的心，那日子就如同网罗忽然临到你们。
But take heed to yourselves, lest your hearts be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and cares of this life, and that they come upon you unexpectedly.
这里告诉我们要谨慎，要特别小心呢。
This verse teaches us to be very careful.
要小心啊，不然会摔跤，会滑倒啊。
To take heed, lest we fall down.
啊，那个危险是什么？
What is the danger?
叫贪食啊，醉酒啊，今生的思虑。
Carousing, drunkenness, and cares of this life.
啊，那个事情临到的时候，就好像网罗临到，就被绑住，被绑住，那就不是很快乐的事情啊。
And these things will come upon a person like a snare.
所以影响轻信的原因呢，就是对于物质哈的忧虑。
So one factor that affects a person's heart is to be too worried or anxious about life.
那我们忧虑什么？
What are the things we can be anxious about?
当然是为了生活而忧虑呀。
Of course, people are anxious about their livelihood.
因为人的生活是非常现实的。
Because making a living is something very practical.
因为 要找吃的东西才能够维持我们的生命呢、啊。
You need to in order to make a living, you need to earn money.
我们要出去赚钱才能够买衣服穿呢、啊。
And you need to make money in order to buy clothes to wear.
才能够有一间房子来住啊，不管是住还是买的都好啊，总是要付一些钱。
Have a roof over your head. All of these require money.
所以生活是很现实的。
So these are very practical things.
所以我们就为了生活来忧虑。
And because of that, we tend to be anxious about life.
啊，为了自己的生命来忧虑。
And we are worried about our lives, our livelihood.
为了自己的健康来忧虑。
About our health.
啊，为了明天来忧虑。
About our tomorrow.
因为这些都是未知数了。
All these are unknowns.
那是我们不能够掌控的。
They are beyond our control.
啊，人们自然就会忧虑。
That's why people are worried.
当然，忧虑，主就说啊，没有用的。不用忧虑的话，也不能够让我们长高一寸。
Do not be worried because worrying cannot make our stature any taller.
也不能够让我们寿命啊多活一刻钟啊。
And we cannot live an hour longer just by worrying.
但是我们人啊有很多的万一怎么办？万一。
But as human beings, we tend to ask, what if?
扫罗以前也是因为是万一万一在这样的情况之下他做错了事情呢。
Saul worried so much, he kept asking what if, and because of that he made a serious mistake.
那他所忧虑的事情是谁告诉他的？其实没有，他是自己心里面在想的。
And all his worries were not real, they were from within his own mind.
就我们心里所想的，可能那些事情都不会发生在我们身上啊。
So the things that we think about may not even happen.
但是已经怕在心里头了。
But we worry already.
有的人啊，不敢搭飞机啊。
Some people are afraid to get on the airplane.
为什么不敢搭飞机？
Why are they afraid?
他碰到恐怖分子攻击啊。
They are afraid of terrorists.
出门要带着好几本的护照。
And they bring many passports.
万一美国护照不通的话，你看这个台湾护照还是中国的护照。
When they go travel, just in case they get in trouble with a U.S. passport, at least they have other foreign passports.
有很多忧虑。
So some people have a lot of worries.
但是这些都是多余的。
But all these are really unnecessary.
那还有人际关系的比较与竞争呢，也会让我们失去清新。
And human relationships as well as competitions among people can take away our purity of heart.
再请看回来诗篇七十三篇。
Please come back to Psalm 73.
七十三篇。
73.
第二节。
Verse 2.
至于我的脚啊，几乎是闪，我的脚险些滑倒。
But as for me, my feet had almost stumbled, my steps had nearly slipped.
说这是为什么？主耶稣说，你们要小心，要谨慎呐，不然会像这个作者，他脚呢会滑倒的。
This is why our Lord Jesus warned us to take heed, because or else we may fall and slip like this psalmist's description.
那为什么作者的脚啊，差点就滑倒？
Why does the psalmist's feet almost stumble?
第三节。
Verse 3.
因为呢，我见恶人和狂傲的人想平安啊，就心怀不平。
For I was envious of the boastful when I saw the prosperity of the wicked.
所以他看见就比较啊，你看这些作恶的人啊，他反而想平安呢、啊。
He compared himself to these evil doers and saw how prosperous they were.
我很老实的在排队，老是排不到，因为总是有人会插队啊。
I'm so honest. I wait in line, but people always cut in front of me.
我想说、啊、警察会来干涉，还是警察都不来。
You would think that the cops would come and do something, but they don't.
结果那些插队的人，很快就把事情办好了。
And those who cut in front of you get their what they needed done right away.
我这个不敢插队的人，傻傻的在这边等啊，一直等啊。
But because you're so honest, you just wait in line forever.
所以心怀不平。
So you feel very envious.
心怀不平就失去了清新的那种感觉享受啊。
But because of such envy, you lose that purity as well as peace in your heart.
再看第五节。
Let's read verse 5.
他们不向别人受苦，也不向别人遭殃啊，遭灾。
They are not in trouble as other men, nor are they plagued like other men.
所以好像什么事坏的事情都不会发生在他们身上。
Seems like nothing bad ever happens to these people.
可是不好的事情都是发在好人，就是发生在这些老实的人的身上。
Whereas bad things always happen to innocent and good people.
所以我才说清心的人啊，眼前吃亏，眼睛好像看不到神的照顾啊。
That's why I said, the person who's pure in heart, tends to be at a disadvantage often.
这个作者啊，他是看见那些坏人、那些作恶的人的情形啊。
And the author of this psalm, saw, situations with these wicked people.
他看见他就比较啊。
And when he saw their situation, he compared himself to them.
他跟我比较。
He compared them and himself.
看是很好，因为神让我们两个眼睛就可以看呐、啊，我们两个眼睛是要看的。
It's good to see. God gave us eyes to God gave us eyes to see.
但是看是要欣赏的喽、啊、不是要去嫉妒别人，不是要跟别人比较的。
But our eyes are for us to appreciate rather than to compare and or to be envious.
只要比较的话，会让我们去犯罪的。
When we compare ourselves with others, we tend to sin.
会让我们失去平安跟喜乐。
We tend to lose our peace and joy.
会让我们害怕。
We tend to become afraid.
害怕我比不上别人呢、啊。
We fear that we cannot be as good as the other person.
比什么？比他？我看到的那个人呢、啊？
We compare ourselves to the next person.
我们看亚当跟夏娃他们两个人吃了善恶树上的果子以后。
After Adam and Eve had eaten of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil,
他们两个人的眼睛就明亮的。
Their eyes were enlightened.
我们想说明亮很好啊，就不用戴眼镜嘛，对不对？
You would think that having your eyes open is something good.
这明亮是不好啊。
But it was not a good thing.
哎，那明亮了以后，他就看到别人，也看到自己。
Because after their eyes were opened, they saw others as well as themselves.
就是比较。
They started to compare.
就看到自己的缺乏。
They saw what they lacked.
看到自己的赤身裸体。
They saw their nakedness.
看到自己的羞耻。
They saw their shame.
他说很害怕。
They became afraid.
这个是从比较来的。
And this is the result of comparing yourself with others.
那你害怕就不会清醒，这个心让你清格起来。
When a person is afraid, how can he be pure in heart?
然后你看到别人，你就嫉妒他。
When you see others better than you, you become jealous.
啊，不管他是不是值不值得得到成功，得到那一种的享受。
Even though they may not be worthy of your admiration.
那我们心怀不平。
We may feel envious.
所以我们已经失去平安跟喜乐了。
Then we lose our purity in heart.
所以你看亚当跟夏娃，他们为了遮羞，用那个树叶的来做衣服遮羞。
Adam and Eve had to make clothes of leaves to cover their shame.
那他们更害怕，因为他们会想说，万一呀，这个树叶被风吹走了怎么办？
But then they were always afraid that the wind may come and blow the leaves away.
万一啊，这个树叶被太阳晒干了怎么办？
And what if the leaves wither when the sun comes out?
越想越害怕。
So the more they think, the more worried they become.
那竞争呢？竞争就是必须要压倒别人，你才会出头啊。
When a person is competitive, he has to step above others.
那当然，你压倒别人以后，你觉得很高兴呢。
And when you can crush your rival, of course you're happy.
你会看到他们得胜那种喜悦，哇，何瑞啊，就一直喊。
People who are competitive will boast of their victory.
啊，可是万一被压倒的话，也很不好受的。
But when they are crushed, they cannot take the pain.
啊，那种喜乐的心也会跑掉的。
They cannot have joy in their heart anymore.
那第三个影响我们清醒的原因呢，就是对人的期待还有依赖。
A third possible factor that could take away the purity in our heart is our dependence on others.
我们人对别人有一种期待
or expectations of others. We tend to have expectations of others.
啊，总是希望别人对我尊重。
We expect people to respect us.
希望别人对我夸奖。
We expect people to praise us.
啊，可是往往不是这样子的，往往不是像我们所想的。
But we're really not as good as we may think.
So we 就很伤心呢。
So we become sad.
那这样我们心就不会清。
Then we cannot be pure in heart.
那我们怎么能够清心呢？
How can we be pure in heart?
我这边提到三个原则。
I like to share three points.
第一个就是以神为乐。
The first principle is to rejoice in God.
神很爱我们呢。
God loves us very much.
啊，他差遣他独生子耶稣基督来为我们受苦，为我们死。
He sent His only Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to die for us.
所以我们应该以神为乐。
So we should rejoice in God.
那以神为乐比较实际的意思到底是什么
？What is the more practical meaning of rejoicing in God？
我们看当时玛利亚哈，玛利亚这约瑟的丈夫玛利亚已经怀孕了，怀了耶稣的孕了。
Mary, whose husband was Joseph, was with a child through the Holy Spirit.
当时玛利亚还没结婚呢。
At that time, she was not married yet.
因为她的未婚夫约瑟还没娶她。
Her fiance had not married her yet.
那她怎么会怀孕呢？
Then how could she be with a child?
当然，天使告诉她说，这是从圣灵怀孕的。
The angel told her that she had conceived through the Holy Spirit.
可是几个人能够明白呀？
But how many other people could understand this mystery?
那几个人能够相信
？How many other people would believe her?
所以她必须要接受很大的侮辱了。
So she had to be ready for a lot of shame.
但是圣经说
，But the Bible tells us，
玛利亚以神为乐
，Mary rejoiced in the Lord.
她的表现让我们看出她以神为乐。
And her actions can tell us that she rejoiced in the Lord.
所以以神为乐的意思就是说，他就把这个事情啊，就淡忘，他就不看在眼中了。
So she no longer cared about all these things.
不然他会想说，哇，他会哭啊！你看， 我还没结婚就怀孕。
Otherwise, she would be thinking about it all day and even cry that she was pregnant even though she was unmarried.
怎么能够走出家门啊？
How could she step outside her house?
怎么能够告诉我的朋友啊?
How could she tell this to her friends?
怎么能够告诉她的邻居?
How could she tell this to her neighbors?
因为她总是要出门出去啊。
Eventually, she would have to step outside.
大家看到她还没结婚的怀孕怎么办?
And what would happen when people saw that she was pregnant even though she was not married?
那是会很让她伤心的。
All these things could bring her a lot of grief.
但是她以神为乐。
But she rejoiced in God.
不想那么多。
She would not think about these things.
越想越害怕。
The more she thought, the more afraid she would be.
所以以神为乐的意思是说交托给神啊。
So to rejoice in God means to entrust everything to God.
她从内心真的是交托哦。
She entrusted herself to God from her heart.
说当我们碰到困难的时候。
When we are in difficult times.
当我们的心就清不起来啊。
When we are not able to be pure in heart.
那怎么办呢?
What should we do?
要交托以神为乐。
We need to trust in God and rejoice in God.
要到我们内心呢不会忧虑为止啊。
To the point where we no longer worry in our hearts.
假如我们交托以后。
After we have entrusted ourselves to God.
那内心还有忧虑。
And we still worry.
那就不算是真正的交托。
Then we have not really entrusted ourselves.
所以以神为乐的意思啊就是交托神那我们就不会有忧虑啊。
So to rejoice in God means to entrust ourselves to God so that we will not be worried.
因为凡事都是出于神的，神会负责到底。
Because if it is from God, God Himself will be responsible.
那第二个啊，就是心意更新而变化。
The second way to be pure in heart is to be renewed in the transformation of our hearts.
啊，请看罗马书。
Let's turn to Romans.
十二章第二节。
Chapter 12, verse 1.
罗马书十二章第二节。
Romans chapter 12, verse 1.
不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化，你们要查验为何神的善良、纯全和喜悦的旨意。
And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
那不要效法这个世界，就是这个世界有这个世界的想法。
Do not be conformed to this world, because this world has its own mindset.
因为有些事情是很 common sense 的，是很普通常识的。
Some things are common sense.
假若玛利亚的例子在今天发生的话
If what happened to Mary happens today,
那对今天的人来讲很合乎常理的就是直到怀孕以后就简单嘛堕胎啊
To a lot of people, the solution would be simple. You just abort the baby.
啊，这个就没事的。
And that would solve the problem.
啊，但是呢，我们的想法不是这样子啊。
But we would not think the same.
我们要查验看看什么是神的旨意。
We need to know what is the will of God.
就自己吃亏也不更改呀。
Even when we suffer loss, we should not change.
所以我们要心意更新，变化，想想我们的想法。
We need to be transformed by the renewing of our mind.
就转个弯呢。
We need to look at it differently.
我们看那个税吏长啊，他本来是很有钱的。
The chief tax collector was a very wealthy man.
他有很多权势的。
He was also very powerful.
那他信耶稣以后
，But after he believed in Jesus,
他完全改变他的想法。
He changed his mindset completely.
他就把那些钱去帮助穷人。
He offered his money to help the poor.
直到后来他剩下的可能不多了。
He probably did not have much left.
那对他的生活可能有一些影响。
It must have a great impact on his life.
他就不能够过着一个很奢华艳丽的生活了。
He could no longer live in luxury.
他必须要过着一个节俭的日子。
He had to become more thrifty.
一般人说啊，你为什么那么傻呢？
Other people may ask him, why are you so foolish?
那信耶稣就信耶稣嘛，你为什么还要拿钱去帮助穷人？
You can believe in Jesus, but why help the poor with your money?
为什么还要拿钱去还那些你以前帮人家多收税的那些人呢？
Why pay back the people that you've extorted?
但是他想法改变了。
But because his mind has changed.
他以神为乐。
He rejoiced in God.
因为他觉得我这样子才会让我的心很清啊。
Because this was the way for him to be pure in heart.
我这样子才会让我得到喜乐快乐啊。
This was how he could regain his joy.
但是一般的想法可能不是这样子的。
But the people of the world may not think the same.
所以叫心理更新的变化。
So we need to be transformed by the renewing of our mind.
看什么的想法才能合乎神的旨意。
And think about what is the good will of God.
而不是用自己的想法。
and not count on our own will.
那这个想法可能是一般人世界的想法。
Our own will and mind may be that of the world.
所以圣经告诉我们，洗净自己衣服的人有福了。
So the Bible tells us, blessed are those who wash their robes.
我们经常洗我们的思想观念。
We need to constantly cleanse our thoughts and our mind.
那越来越合乎圣经的想法。
So that they conform to the way of the Bible.
让我们心念能够清下来。
This will help us become pure in heart.
那第三个啊。
The third way.
我们请看罗马书。
Please turn to Romans.
第八章。
Chapter 8.
三十七节。
Verse 37.
三十七
，verse 37。
罗马书八章三十七节
，Romans 8:37。
然而靠着爱我们的主，在这一切的事上已经得胜有余了。
Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors to him who loved us。
啊，要做到清心也不简单呢。
It's not easy to be pure in heart。
因为讲比较快呀。
It's easy to say。
啊，说你不要烦恼啊，不要操心哦。
Don't worry, don't be anxious。
啊，我的困难不是你的困难了，您讲比较快呀，我也会讲啊。
But you are not the one who is dealing with the problems, so it's easy for you to say, do not be worried.
那真正人们能够做到清心。
But how can a person really be pure in heart?
让我们能够以神为乐。
And rejoice in God.
啊，就是要靠主啊。
We need to do it through the Lord.
啊，主要祷告一个途径啊。
And prayer is one way.
那圣灵被称为更新的灵。
The Holy Spirit is a spirit that renews.
那神要透过圣灵把他的爱加灌在我们内心。
God will pour out His love into our hearts through His Spirit.
神要透过圣灵，让我们心里的我的力量刚强起来。
And God, through the Holy Spirit, can strengthen our inner being.
我们就能够克服那些忧虑、恐惧。
And this will help us conquer our fear.
就能够让我们的心呐、啊。真正的能清心
and our worries, so that we can be truly pure in heart.
能够享受主里的平安
and enjoy the peace that is in the Lord.
再唱诗
Let us sing him.
228首
228.